Viewer discretion is advised, rated R, for retardedness, swearing, alcoholism, homosexuality, and possible bestiality.
Fishing can be a pretty expensive hobby, or job, as some of us do for a living. But you have to remember, you know, in this bad economy, money is really tight with your parents, having trouble making ends meet. So what you got to do is really encourage your old man to drink, because the way I figure is you're going to go buy a $40 t-shirt anyway. So you might as well go and make sure there's a nice special on. Canadian, I'm sporting one of their t-shirts right here. They're usually good. Pretty much any just midline domestic beer, nothing fancy, nothing imported, unless it's imported from the States, you know what I mean. But basically you'll get a t-shirt and you get a free case of beer. A few other ways you can save money is what I like to do every time I catch a fish is I like to see what it's been eating. And that's not so much so I can match my lure to it, although that's also a good idea. But sometimes you get, you know, half-eaten worm stuck right down the gullet. And if you get your fingers in there, you can save that worm and you can reuse it. You know, so that'll save you money in the long run. Stay tuned. We'll have some more fishing tips coming up next.
As an aside, I'm almost done untangling my line.
Yeah, so here we are out on Sandy Lake. Been out for about 10 minutes. We've already caught three or four. We've got Rob, and Mike. And hopefully we're going to have a good fishing day if the rain holds off. And there we go. Rob's got one on. Looks like a nice little smallmouth. He's just got to make sure he doesn't horse it.
Oh, she's going
deep.
There we
go.
She's going deep. Oh, Jesus, Kurt. I don't know. I might need the net. Oh, look at her jump. Oh, yeah. I think I got her all tired out now. Whoo! That's what I'm talking about. That's fishing in Nova Scotia right there for you, boy.
Here we've got a Gerber multi-tool. Got this for standing at my buddy Corey's wedding. And, you know, it's the handiest thing because, you know, if you happen to buy a steam whistle, the Good Beer Folks, which is our one of our non-official sponsors, it's perfect. Just flip her back, and there you go. You're getting drunk as a lord before you know it. Steam whistle beer.
Do you like it?
No, and there we go. There's another one. Mike's got it. Yeah, not too much size to it, but still a nice little fish. Good for the goldfish bowl.
I think we should have.
All right there, boys and girls. As you can see, we've got, you know, these three guys are doing something right. First of all, they don't have their life jackets on, which, you know, allows you to catch a lot more fish, more mobility. But one reason why they're not catching a whole lot of fish is because, if you notice, they don't have any beer open. You know, that's number one rule, beer and smokes. And as you can see, I'm doing things right. There we go, right there, folks. That's the way to do it. Despite not having beer, Rob just had a bite, but he pretty much shit the bed and lost it. So let's see if he can have better luck in the future.
Well, I've lost three fish now already, and I think I'm having the same problem that I have when I go out to the bar and pick up the ladies. Is, as you see, the tool that I'm using is a little too big for their mouth. And I don't think they're getting it all the way in before they spit it out. Seems to be a common theme in my life. I'm going to have to look into this.
Yeah, and it looks like Mike's got a nice one there. He's getting a pretty good pull. Once again, fishing with just a straight hook and a worm. And let's see what we got there.
Trick my old grandfather taught me.
Oh, that's all right. Not a bad size. Pretty feisty. Now you see, for you kids at home, it's all important to have that divider right there in your live well. Because for obvious reasons, you know, you can stick beer in there, have the lake keep them nice and cold. Right now we're drinking Canadian cold shots. And then the left side, you can keep your fish, so you can keep them nice and fresh too. It's only smart. It's only smart there, folks. Get that divider, and you know, you can drink and fish at the same time. And for all you kids watching out there, always have a pair of needle nose pliers. Saves your fingers. Saves the fish sometimes. Oh, what do you think about that, Rob?
Yeah, this one's fucked.
Yeah.
She swallowed her.
No, well, it happens.
She swallowed it, damn.
Yeah, so here we are in the bay, and this is pretty much what Rob said about 10 minutes ago. Hey, I got a good idea. Let's go to anchor, and then we can catch some fish, because we're marking lots. Yeah, but unfortunately, we haven't caught fuck all, and, you know, what do you have to say about that, Rob?
Well, I guess I'm just going to say I just had a little bite there. Fortunately, he took a run. And as you notice, the cameraman didn't want to show you. Looks like Mike's got a fish right now. You know, there goes my bobber again.
Yeah. Well, fuck me. I'm deleting this bastard then.
I'm not gonna bring that one in. Oh, looks like he got off.
Yeah. That's some good work. Good work. Well, maybe we'll stay here for a couple more minutes, and you know, then I'll make fun of you there.
Alright there, folks. You know, when you're fishing with us, sometimes, you know, when you're not smart, you like to go in the shallowest place possible so that you've got the potential to, you know, do the most damage to your boat. You don't want to damage the trolling motor because it's made out of space age material, probably developed by like NASA, maybe a couple astronauts, stuff like that. So when you're going through narrow channels like this and it's, you know, half a foot, you want to make sure that you damage your boat instead of your trolling motor. So what I like to do is when I'm going through really shallow stuff, pull the motor up like that, just get her down about, you know, 3-4 inches, and then you're good to burn through.
When you go fishing for a smallmouth bass, you know, using a basically a salmon rod and a 48-pound test, shit's going to get fucked up. You know, it's just to be expected.
See, if I didn't buy a way cool four-wheeler, I could afford to buy a fishing rod.
Yeah, well, your fucking four-wheeler is helping you out a lot here today, isn't it? Yeah, I don't see your four-wheeler catching much fish.
No, neither am I.
Well, it's a good thing if we lose our anchor rope, we've got plenty of that line.
There we go. Well, can't lose my slash bait.
Well, I just want to take the opportunity there to throw out a happy Canada Day to all of our viewers from Canada. Of course, they'd always wait till I start talking before I get a bite. But, you know, I'd just like to say that after this, we're probably going to go cut some wood. And, you know, if there's a hockey game on, we might even go do it doggy style while watching the game. But, yeah, it's just a little bass let go. It saw I was doing an interview right now, so it couldn't.
Sorry, what are you going to do doggy style?
No, when I'm watching the hockey game.
Right.
There's no hockey.
Yeah, I've got the NHL Classic channel.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Not the smartest bunch out here, folks. Remember to stay in school.